In this lecture, we'll talk briefly about evaluating the industries that are available for a firm to diversify into or to become part of, and also firms that one is competing with, how their diversification strategies might work. We'll talk about a technique which can be useful in ranking companies and thinking about and discussing in a team setting, a group setting, a operating council type setting, what the strategic situation of a firm might be. You want to look at various industries and you see how attractive that industry might be for my firm to enter. Say I'm an industrial firm that manufactures or makes some sort of a product that's a petroleum-based product like gasoline or something like that. Do I want to backward integrate, forward integrate? Do I want to sell additional products? Some of my products or some of my materials are sold into chemical industry and the like. How do I look at those various industries and see where it might make sense for me to expand my business in a diversification strategy, a corporate strategy? Does the industry represent a good possible market? Is it growing fast? Is it an attractive market generally? Which of the ones that are available to me are the most attractive ones that one can imagine? They're growing fast. I seem to have some sort of a competitive advantage there. Perhaps it reduces my distribution costs. Perhaps somewhere in my value chain I can make use of resources and capabilities that I already have. We'll talk about some of those things later. So how appealing is a whole group of industries and how do they relatively stack up one to the other? Might be something you would think about. You think about cross-industry strategic fit, in other words, things that I do extremely well, perhaps logistics. Does it apply also to that industry that I'm looking at? Is that somewhere that I can be supportive of, cut down on the cost of distribution, whatever? Do the resource requirements in that industry match the kinds of things that I have, the cash requirements? Do I have business units that are generating a lot of cash that I could apply in that industry to perhaps upgrade, innovate, make new technologies or whatever? Or other resources that I might have, for example, back office distributed data processing expertise or whatever that might bring a particular industry further along with some innovative processes that I can use to make that industry attractive from my perspective. So you want to look at those various items that you might think about the industry and its attractiveness. They'll vary by industry. This is a sort of conceptual way of sort of quantifying some things, this technique I'll describe, quantifying some things that are essentially qualitative, but at least one can think about and compare them. So decide on appropriate weight. Something is 10% of value, or it's out of one on a scale of 1 to 10, this industry is a 5 in terms of its use of distribution strategies or distribution capabilities. It might be a 7 in terms of its growth, maybe a 4 in terms of its profitability, those kinds of things. Then you want to make sure you go out and gather real data. You're not shooting from the hip. You're looking and studying the players in that industry to get real knowledge about those various factors in the industry. So you could set the weights as reasonably as you possibly can and see if they impact different business units in a different way. Then you might want to think about laying all those things out and the factors that you're interested in, you know, profitability, growth, that sort of thing, use of technology, use of resources, and the different industries, and you put weights to them. You know, so a larger weight for something that's important and not so large a weight for something that's less important. This is an example of a chart that you might do do that. And this is the sort of thing that you use, the fact that a bunch of experts in a room are smarter than any one individual. So you would talk about market size and growth and say that the importance of this to my particular strategy might be a 0.1 out of 10. Whereas the intensity of the competition is very important. Maybe you don't want that much intensity, so that's a 0.25. You just relatively get a consensus around the thought process of the team and evaluate these different scores and different weights, how important they are, how that particular industry plays out. And essentially, it's a way to compare them, to have a dialogue or discussion that has factual basis to it, even though it's evaluated in this sort of weighting sense. But you can have a good discussion among a team about where you find opportunities and where you don't find opportunities when you're looking at various industries. So that's one way to be thinking about how you begin to evaluate from a corporate strategy perspective where you want to take additional strategic moves in other industries, either in related investment or unrelated investment, depending upon your approach. We'll continue to talk about this, about the possibilities in the next lecture. Bring this back. Well, we'll talk about how one thinks about, this was thinking about the attractiveness of the industries. Here we want to look at the business units that we have in those industries or other players that one might merge with, buy, compete with, how their business units play out in those various industries. So that's what we'll talk about next. Business unit strength in the context of this industry attractiveness matrix. That will be our next lecture.